Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today in this video, we are going to work with the Video Copilot ORB plugin in HitFilm Pro version 14. So like I said, I'm going to be working in HitFilm Pro version 14, but if you're watching this video at a later date, then it will most likely work in whatever version you are working in. The first thing you need to do is download and install Video Copilot's ORB plugin. So what you want to do is go to videocopilot.net/ORB, and there is a link in the description below. If you come down on the page, you will find Download Now, Windows Download, Mac Download, and also Earth Download. So you want to download whichever version you're using. I use the Windows download. And also you will want to download the Earth textures. Then you will want to install it by double-clicking or by unzipping it and then double-clicking the install application. When you have double-clicked it, then you will get this VC ORB for After Effects installer. You want to agree to the terms, clicking I agree. And then you will want to select custom by ticking this box, and then you will click on plugin path to point it to the right place. The right place will be wherever you have installed HitFilm. In my case, it's in the Program Files, FX Home, HitFilm Pro, Plugins folder. And when you say select folder, then it shows that path here in the installer. Then all you have to do is click install. You will want to unzip the textures and place them into a folder. I have created a folder called Earth Textures 6K. Now these textures are very large. They are 6,000 by 3,000. The Planet 4K one is 4,096 by 4,096 pixels. That's a lot of pixels. And when I worked on my computer in HitFilm, it would cause HitFilm to lock up. They were too big. So what I did was I took these and I right-clicked on them and I said open with paint. And then I said resize, and I resized them to 25% of their original size, which in this case makes it 1024 by 1024 pixels, which is about 6.25% of the original size. I then saved this as its own texture, and then I brought that into HitFilm. So now that I am in HitFilm Pro version 14, what I want to do is create a new composite shot and click OK. Then I want to create a plane that is the size of the timeline, in this case 1920 by 1080, clicking OK. If you have installed the Video Copilot plugin correctly, there will be under the Effects tab a new folder called Video Copilot. If you open that folder up, you'll see the VC ORB layer only effect on there. You're going to drag that onto the new plane and poof, there is your ORB. And what I want to do is open up and create a new light that will be shining on this ORB. This will basically act as my sun, and you can see that if I move this around a little bit, that it interacts with the ORB very, very nicely. Okay, I'm going to rename that to Sun, and I'm going to go ahead and rename my plane to Planet, just so that I know what it is. I want to go ahead and bring in my planet texture. You can see it has been reduced. And then I'm going to tick off the visibility because I don't want it to actually be seen. Now I can double click on the ORB plug-in effect, and it will bring it up here in the Controls tab. The first thing I want to do, if I choose to, is to change the radius of the planet. I'm going to make this planet just a little bit bigger so that it's easier to see in my camera. If I were to select this orbit around a selected layer tab, then I can actually orbit around and see this as I move my camera. Basically, I'm choosing to move my camera around. I can always reset the current view this way. Okay. From here, under Maps, I'm going to select as the diffuse layer the texture that I put in the in the composite shot here. Also, I want to select that for my glossiness layer and also the bump map layer as well. And now you can see that I have this very nice looking orb and I can start playing around with it. So this is going to be a little bit of a walkthrough here in terms of different things that I can do with regards to this to make it look more like a planet and less like a plastic ball with a bunch of bumps on it. If I open up UV, then you can see that I have UV type is spherical. What I want to do is change this to box. Okay. What this will do is create a different looking way of mapping the texture onto the planet. And this may show some of the seams as a result. So what I want to do is just up the feathering a little bit here so that the seams are not as visible. And maybe also double up on the repeating for X and Y. That way, the textures look very nice and they look very, very solid here in terms of the, making it look more like a planet texture itself. Now, there's a pretty big shine here on the planet itself from the light. But if I can adjust the glossiness gamma a little bit, I can push it up to make it less shiny, or I can bring it down. Either way, this just kind of reduces the size of the shine. This sort of dissipates the shine over the entire planet. I'm just going to go up to sort of dissipate the shine over the entire planet. So now I want to create a little bit of atmosphere to it. So what I will do is under material, I'm going to increase the illumination, and you can see that it is increasing the illumination all the way around. But if I open up the illumination options, you have Fresnel, and if you increase this, then it will sort of push that towards the edges. And then if I adjust the Fresnel bias, I can really push that to the very, very edge. I can change the illumination color to something else. Since it's a green texture, I think I will make it more of a green looking atmosphere. Although I could make it any color that I wanted to. And then if I want this not to be glowing on the dark side, but I want it to glow on the front side, then what I need to do is just adjust the shadow light expansion so that it is on the high side here. And then as I change the shadow contrast, sliding it a little bit to the right, I am bringing it so that it's mostly over here on the edge. And so now you can see that on the light side, there's sort of an atmosphere, and on the dark side, not so much, right? And that's basically the idea here behind the using the orb effect to create a planet. Next week, what I want to do is make a video on how to create the Earth using this same plugin. So stay tuned for that. In the meantime, if you like this kind of a content, please do me a favor and like this video, share it with your friends. Also, feel free to subscribe to the channel and click the bell icon for notifications. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. Otherwise, thanks for watching.